Exciting news this week if you're an Adobe Premiere Pro user. It's Adobe Max this week, and they've just announced Adobe Premiere Pro CC 2019. There's loads of new updates, so I'm going to run through a few of them now. I'm Mark from Editor's Keys, and if you want to see more videos like this about video editing tips and tutorials, make sure you subscribe to the channel now. But first of all, let's go through the new updates in Adobe Premiere. So the first new update is an update to the motion graphics and essential graphics panel within Adobe Premiere. For the first time now, you can now re-edit some of the text and fonts within your graphics. And whilst this is great going forward, you're not going to be able to do this on some of the past graphics that you've made, but it's a really cool, great new feature that I think a lot of people are going to love. In addition to that, you're going to be able to create some great infographics. First of all, you need to create a graphic within Adobe After Effects, and then you can use an Excel sheet to actually pull in the data. So if you're creating, say, an infographic for a client, and you have loads of things in a chart or a graph, you can now make some really cool motion graphics with that. And the great thing is about this update is that if you update the Excel sheet, it updates all of the information straight into your graphics within After Effects and then Adobe Premiere. So I think that's really cool. Next, there's some really cool updates in the audio tab. For those of you that record in some noisy environments, you'll be pleased to know Adobe have made some great work in the audio improvements area. There's now a new noise removal tool, which allows you to get rid of a lot of background noise. So if you're in a room or an area with air conditioning, traffic, and things like that, this new tool really helps to dial down that background noise. Next up in the new audio sort of cleanup area of Adobe Premiere, there's some great updates if you happen to record in large rooms or rooms with a lot of reverb or echo. The new reverb tool will actually help you to get rid of reverb. So if you've recorded, let's say, in a church or a hall and you get that echoey sound, you'll be able to bring that audio into Premiere or take it from your video and then dial back the reverb so it gives you nice, crispy, clean audio. So the next tool is really great, and it's something that Andy at Editor's Keys has been super excited about. It's the selective color grading tool. And this basically means you can, say, select a color within your image. So you could color pick this shirt, for example, and then you can change just the hue, the saturation, the luminance, and things like that, just in the shirt without affecting the wider color within your shot. And I think that's really great. There's a lot of situations we've been in where we've been in a room and there's a particular sort of yellow light in the room, or say the table is giving off a horrible color. You'll be now able to go in, just adjust that particular color and get some great looking video. Some other cool features worth mentioning are the ability to actually edit vector images directly within Premiere. So if you're an Adobe Illustrator or you have some graphics, you can now actually manipulate those vector graphics directly within Premiere. It's especially good if you make lower thirds or graphics and you bring them in from Adobe Illustrator. It's great that you have that added flexibility and you can now edit those graphics. Next is also great if you film on your iPhone 8 or iPhone 10. They now have the support in Adobe Premiere Pro 2019 for the high efficiency codecs, which the iPhone 10 uses to film on. You may have noticed before, if you've been out on the road and you've filmed with your iPhone 10 and you've tried to import that footage, you might have seen it doesn't really play back properly, or you might have problems importing or exporting that footage. That codec is now there, so you can now shoot on your iPhone and edit that footage directly within Premiere, which is pretty great. So I hope you love these new updates to Adobe Premiere Pro. Have you come up against any bugs or problems with your version of Premiere? Or have you tried out the new version of Adobe Premiere Rush? If you have, leave a comment below and I promise we'll get back to every single comment. Just make sure you subscribe to the channel to see more videos like this one. Thanks a lot, and I'll see you in the next video.